so long ago, I finally got my driving license. And this whole year, full of suffering, sweaty hands, and humiliation, is still quite fresh in my mind. With horror, I'm still thinking about all this. Check the gears. Gas, 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 keep going! And then suddenly, slow down. We stopped near McDonald's, and my instructor asked me to order coffee for him. You know, at these self-serve machines. But honestly, I felt quite embarrassed, as I've never used them before. So I said, rather quietly, one cappuccino. Nothing. I repeated, in a more loud voice, one cappuccino. Still no reaction. For my third try, I pumped air into my lungs, having every intention of prevailing the stubborn machine, when my instructor extremely calmly asked, maybe you could try with the opened car window. Dear fellow Toastmasters and friends, that was an example of what stress can do to us. And this case is not unique, because all our lives are full of stressful situations. Some people can stress about stress even before there is stress to be stressed about. You can just watch my hands during this presentation to understand the level of my anxiety today. Nowadays, there are a lot of different strategies of how to combat stress. But do you really think all these methods work? If so, tomorrow morning, try to get into the metro coach just before that old lady with three bags looking for an empty place. So, the main purpose of my today's discourse is to propose you really efficient tips of how to break up with stress. And the first one is, stop hurrying up and just take your time. After one day, I left City Mall with a pair of brand new shoes of different sizes. I never hustle while shopping anymore. Then, on the theoretical classes in my driving school, the teacher told us, don't be afraid of anything, try it. The instructor will always be here with you to help you in any difficult situation. I suspect that maybe he hated someone of his colleagues. Nevertheless, first times at the wheel, I felt like a goddess. I was driving, and my instructor was praying. Considering we haven't exceeded the speed level of 5 km/h. I mean, when you are sure that you're doing is right, you won't be stressed out. So treat yourself as you deserve it, and don't be afraid of anything. Moving forward, I would like to share with you some information I read several days ago. According to it, if you sleep 12 nights for not more than 6 hours, the condition of your body will be as if you had 0.1% of alcohol in your blood. My first conclusion was, God, I'm drunk almost all the time. But on the second thought, I understood that stress caused by a sleep deficit can be self-healing. So let me explain. When people don't sleep enough, they are stressed. But at the same time, lack of sleep leads to this drunk feeling. And many people try to reduce stress drinking alcohol. So your stress should be diffused. My second conclusion was, some problems can be solved just by themselves. And now, imagine the following situation. You are going to have a really serious conversation about the postponing of the deadline with one of the most important stakeholders of your project. To say that you will be feeling nervous is not to say anything. But I have a really great tip for you to calm down. Just look for this person in social network and watch his photos. The next time you'll be contacted him, believe me, this will be the first that comes to your mind. And finally, for my last tip, I would need your help. Are you ready?
Yes.
So, first of all, take a deep breath. And now, I want you to put the shape of a smile on your face. It doesn't have to be a real smile, I just need to see your teeth, like this. Turn and make eye contact with the person on your left or right? Thank you. Actually, that's it. But now you have a really powerful tool. The next time you'll be sitting at your desk at work, and understand that if one more person gives you one more thing to do, you'll literally explode. Just make this. Believe me, next person came into the room seeing you like that will understand that now it's not the right time to bother you. To conclude, I want you to take a look at all these tips again. And if you still have any doubts, I'm going to get them cleared right now. So for this, take a second look, but more attentively. You see? So, I do hope that this presentation has convinced you and will help you to make your life a little less stressful. Anyway, don't take your life too seriously, because you won't get out alive. Thank you very much for your attention.